So what actually causes night driving blur, where your vision actually might be fine during the day, but it's extra blurry at night? And this can include glare, halos, light streaks coming off headlights and streetlights, extra haze, reduced contrast. Maybe the street signs are extra blurry, or maybe you even have night blindness called nyctalopia. Well, we're going to go over all of the many different causes of this, plus give you solutions and tips that can actually improve your vision at night. Let's focus in. Now, blurry night vision can be broken down into two categories. Number one, the image or the light from that image traveling to you and through your eye is either being obstructed, scattered, or defocused. And then number two, the retina in the back of your eye is not working properly. So we're gonna break it down into each step from the image to the retina, and we're gonna go over a lot of detail here. I originally thought I was gonna break this down into multiple different videos, but I thought this will just be nicer to have everything in this video for reference. So don't be afraid to use the timestamps below if you wanna jump to a certain section. Okay, jumping right into it. The first section, the light coming from the image to your eye. The biggest thing you can do here is to make sure that there is nothing scattering or obstructing that image. Now, this usually starts with the windshield. So I know this is said a lot, but make sure that windshield is clean. If there's any smudges, dust, cracks or streaks or hard water spots, that all can scatter or block light. And sometimes people that are seeing light streaks coming from headlights or streetlights actually is caused from the windshield and not necessarily your eye. And so make sure that that windshield is nice and clear, at least the best you can. And the same principle applies to your glasses. If you wear anything over your eyes, any kind of fingerprint, smudge, oil, dirt can scatter light and just add to the whole mess. So make sure that you have your glasses, your lenses as clean as you can. Section number two, speaking of glasses, if you wear glasses, make sure that it's up to date. If it's been a while since your last eye exam, like your last vision check, go in and make sure that your glasses have the current updated prescription. If you have even the slightest uncorrected astigmatism, myopia, nearsightedness, or farsightedness, it can actually make a pretty big difference, especially at nighttime when you're driving. Now, even if you have great vision, 20/20 vision, daytime you see like a hawk, I would still go in and get your eyes checked. There is something called night myopia or night nearsightedness, where some people at night in low lit conditions or dark environments, their pupils will dilate and will cause a myopic shift, or their focus will shift more nearsighted, causing distance images to be blurry, especially at nighttime. Sometimes I'll actually take patients outside in the dark during the evening, and I'll actually put these trial frame glasses on there that has little lenses, little distance prescriptions in there, and kind of test a few and see if it actually improves the night vision. And so sometimes people just need glasses for night driving because they might be someone that has night myopia. Now, if you do wear glasses, definitely consider getting an anti-reflective coating, anti-glare coating on your glasses. When you're wearing glasses and you don't have a coating, when light hits those lenses, that light can bounce around in those lenses and cause multiple reflections and can be very distracting. And so if you wear glasses, definitely consider anti-reflective coating to help eliminate those reflections. Now, that being said, I want you to watch out for certain anti-glare technologies that are offered by certain companies, like the Essilor drive lenses or Shamir moon lenses, or even the Zenni driving glasses. They have anti-glare properties on there that actually are able to filter out certain wavelengths of light where our eyes are more sensitive, especially at nighttime. And this can actually significantly reduce glare and light streaks and haze. And so that is something to consider. Even if maybe you don't wear glasses, it might be something to look into or talk to your doctor about. Now, what about those yellow tinted night driving glasses that you see everywhere on TV and in the stores? Do they actually work? The idea behind these is that yellow tint is designed to increase contrast, to make things pop a little bit more, make things a little bit more vivid. And contrast can actually be a big deal, bigger than a lot of people think. Contrast is the difference of light between two different objects, white on black, black on white. If there's more of a difference in illumination or lighting, then there's more contrast, easier to decipher the two different images and help you see a little bit better. Now, if you're in low light conditions, then the difference in lighting between those two objects definitely decreases, reduces your contrast, and makes nighttime blur even worse. And so that's where these yellow tinted night driving glasses may come in. Now, this is where it gets tricky, is in the studies, there isn't really any concrete evidence that shows that they actually have a benefit at nighttime. That being said, I have a lot of patients that swear by them, that say that's the one thing that makes them feel safe when they're driving at night. And I have a lot of people that have tried them and didn't notice a difference. And so this might be one thing that you could try, but just know that it might not make any difference at all. Now, one thing to stay away from is the really dark yellow tinted glasses or even sunglasses. Those can actually reduce the light even more and actually make things worse. And so if you're gonna look for those, stay away from the darker tinted glasses. Section number three, we're talking about the surface of the eye, including the tear layer and the cornea. Now, I feel like the tear layer really gets underrepresented when we're talking about nighttime vision. Now, if you think about it, as light is traveling through the air and gets to your eye, the first thing that the light hits on your eye is actually the tears, the tear layer of the eye. So if your tear layer is thin or it's evaporating too fast or drying out, then you kind of get off to a bad start right at the beginning. As the light hit the tears and the tears are not doing well, it can actually cause those symptoms of glare and scattering light and blurry vision. And this is where the discussion of dry eye comes into play. Again, dry eye, I don't see this really mentioned in a lot of other videos, where how much dry eye can actually play a role in night driving blur. And this is something to pay attention to if you want to know if this is your issue. When you're driving at night, if you notice that the glare and halos and the blurry vision kind of fluctuates, maybe it's there and then you're able to blink and kind of squeeze your eyelids and maybe it gets better and then it goes bad again, or maybe you're able to kind of rub your eyes a little bit, get some tears going on in the eyes, and then your vision's a little bit better, you could be dealing with a dry eye issue or a poor tear film quality issue. So one thing that you can try or do an experiment is throughout the day use preservative-free artificial tears, especially if you're working on a computer screen all day long, and drinking more water. And then right before you go drive home, use an eye drop. And if that seems to help, allows you to reduce your glare and improve your clarity, then you could be dealing with a dry eye issue. Now, if you are unlucky, sometimes dry eye disease can be very complicated and actually worse and hard to treat. And so if you are dealing with this, it's best to go in and get your eyes checked by your eye doctor and see what solutions might actually work the best for you. And in the meantime, you can check out my whole playlist about dry eyes, all my videos about dry eyes that I've done, and I'll put that link in the description underneath the like button. Now, speaking of dryness, now moving to the cornea itself can actually dry out. It actually can turn a little bit hazy and actually can develop dry patches right on the surface of the cornea called keratitis. The same thing, like if your hands dry out, it'll develop dry patches, maybe cracks on the surface of the skin. Same thing can actually happen to the cornea. And those dry patches, as you can imagine, if light hits it, those dry patches will scatter the light everywhere and add to all of those symptoms. So really, dry eyes can cause a number of issues that can contribute to all of those symptoms. Now, again, not a lot of people talk about this one, but I would feel like dry eyes is probably one of my top reasons that contributes to difficulty night driving blur, at least for me. Now, if you are curious how much dry eyes can actually affect your eyes, I actually did an experiment where I stayed awake for 24 hours and stared at a computer screen and actually took pictures before and after to see what it did. I'll put these up right here, but if you want to check out that full video to see what it actually did to my eyes, I'll put that link in the description as well. It's pretty interesting. Now, moving to the cornea. The cornea is supposed to be this nice, clear dome where it's actually responsible for 70% of the light that gets focused to the retina. So if you have any imperfections in the tissue of that cornea, then it can actually cause aberrations or distortions in the light. If you have a different type of curve to that dome, maybe one part is more curved than the other, that's what astigmatism is. And astigmatism can definitely cause those symptoms that you get at nighttime. Now, astigmatism is actually huge. In fact, it's the first thing that I think of when a patient comes in and says, hey, my nighttime vision is getting a little tricky. I definitely want to start looking for any astigmatism that has shown up. The word astigmatism means without spot or without point, meaning the eye is not focusing light to a single point. So if you're looking at a point of light, you'll actually see that image stretched out. And that's where some of the light streaks and star patterns come from when looking at headlights or streetlights. And this is caused from a certain part of your cornea being more curved than the other part. Now, the reason why people notice it more at nighttime is because our pupil dilates to let more light in because it's dark. But because it does that, it catches more of that curved area of the cornea. So it starts noticing the edges of the cornea that has to bend light quite a bit more, and it gets bent more. And so you notice more of the streak. Now, luckily with astigmatism, it can be corrected with glasses and contact lenses. Now remember, any even slight minor imperfections in the corneal tissue can cause aberrations. And aberrations can be many different things. In fact, there are many different type of aberrations. There are a couple that can be helped with glasses, and then there are some aberrations called higher order aberrations that aren't really helped with glasses or contact lenses. Now, I'll put up a picture here of all the different types of aberrations that we know about. And if you look at some of these, you might notice that some of these actually look familiar. Especially for me, I notice that I have a few of these, especially when looking at headlights or streetlights, I can actually see some of these aberrations. And this really comes into play if you have had LASIK or are deciding to have LASIK. LASIK can definitely introduce more imperfections into the tissue of the cornea, which can increase some of these aberrations that you'll see at night. That's why they commonly say, hey, one of the side effects of LASIK is increased glare. Now, that being said, there are some type of wavefront guided LASIK procedures that can actually help with those higher order aberrations. There are some aberrations that can be helped with rigid gas permeable contact lenses, hard contact lenses, or scleral lenses. And so there are certain things that we can do to try and at least reduce some of those aberrations. Now, moving a little bit further back in the eye, the pupil. And we actually mentioned this a little bit earlier, where at nighttime, your pupil, the iris, will actually dilate and get bigger, so it can let more light in so you can actually see. But by doing this, can actually cause some of that glare and blurry night vision. And one of the reasons for this is as it dilates, it's like having a large aperture on a camera. The larger the aperture, the more narrow and shallower depth of field, meaning where you're actually focused is actually has a small range that you're dealing with. Now, the smaller the pupil, the closer you get to what's called the pinhole effect, where if your pupil can actually, an iris, can actually get down to the size of a pinhole, then you actually have a really, really large depth of field, a depth of focus, where your focal range is pretty large, meaning there's a lot that's in focus. But one thing you can look into, there are eye drops out there that actually can constrict your pupil to make it smaller. This is usually designed for people that are starting to lose their near focus. You can actually constrict the pupil to improve their vision for near vision. Off-label use, some doctors might prescribe these drops to actually help with your vision at nighttime, to shrink the pupil down a little bit. Now, again, this is off-label, meaning there aren't many studies out there that actually show the evidence of this or show the risks of this. And so definitely talk to your doctor about this. But there are a few drops out there now that you can actually do this with. Section 5, we're dealing with the crystalline lens right behind the iris. And this is another clear structure that's actually responsible for 30% of the focused light to the retina. And this is where cataracts happen. So over time, that lens just adds layers every year. And as it adds layers, it gets thicker and harder. It actually starts to discolor a little bit and maybe develop some opacities in the structure. As you can imagine, those opacities and the coloring can warp and change light and cause a lot of those symptoms. Now, in some of the types of the cataracts, the opacities actually start on the outer edge of that lens in there. Now, at nighttime, because the iris dilates and gets bigger, then some of that light getting into your eye actually hits those opacities at the edge of the lens. And so you'll notice more of problems at nighttime than you would possibly during the daytime. Now, obviously with cataracts, when it gets bad enough and it's ready, then you can actually have a surgery to remove those cataracts. And actually, people's nighttime vision really does significantly improve after that. If you want to look into ways maybe to help prevent or slow the progression of cataracts down, I'll put a list of things that you can do naturally right here so you can pause the video and read those. Section 6. Now we're moving back to the vitreous. That's the vitreous gel or fluid that fills the eye. eye, and light passes through it to get to the retina. And same thing, if you have any opacities in there, it can definitely scatter light. But also one thing, if you have a lot of floaters or even what's called a posterior vitreous detachment, where that gel has peeled away from the retina, this actually can cause a reduced contrast sensitivity and actually can affect your nighttime vision. This is something I don't really see a lot of people talking about. If we're dealing with floaters, there's really a couple of procedures that you can have done. One is called a YAG, where they use a laser to try and break up bigger floaters into smaller pieces, hoping that you won't notice them as well. Or there's something called a vitrectomy, an actual surgery where they go in and remove the vitreous gel that contains the floater within it. And that can actually help quite a bit. Now, will these actually help with your night vision? Probably will depend on the person. Another thing that you can look into is something called Vitreous Health. It's actually a supplement that is designed from a study called the FLY study, where they found a certain cocktail of vitamins actually did improve floater symptoms. Okay, so now we're at section 7. We've finally reached the retina. So this is where the light has passed through all those different structures, hopefully being focused right to the back of your eye, and now it's the retina's job to take that signal and transmit the signal to the brain. So as you can imagine, if there's something wrong with that tissue, something wrong with the rods, there's rods and cones. Rods are primarily more effective at night in perceiving light, and if there's something wrong with that, then you can imagine, yeah, the nighttime vision is going to be affected. Now, this is where a lot of times we're talking about a genetic issue that someone might be born with, where it might be affecting the development of rods or the breakdown of the rods or affecting the retinal tissue. One of the most popular examples a lot of people mention here is retinitis pigmentosa, where a lot of the rods in the periphery of the retina does break down and doesn't work properly. And a lot of these patients do lose visual acuity and definitely have night blindness, where their vision at night is almost non-existent. Now, this is where we're talking about true night blindness, nyctalopia. A lot of people can have symptoms like night blindness or nighttime blur, and will sometimes be called nyctalopia, but this is where it's actually a condition, an actual legit nighttime blindness. Another big topic that you'll hear a lot is a vitamin A deficiency. Now, if someone is truly deficient in vitamin A, then the retina cells won't function properly. We actually need vitamin A to refresh and actually take and create pigment to the retina, which helps absorb light that gets focused to the retina. Now, if someone is truly deficient in vitamin A, then yeah, their night vision will be horrible, nighttime blind, and will have other symptoms as well. Now, luckily, it is pretty rare to be deficient, completely deficient in vitamin A, especially in developed countries. Most people aren't that malnourished. And so the question is, okay, if I'm a little deficient or low on vitamin A, is it okay to take vitamin A supplements to maybe help my nighttime vision? This is a tricky one. This is one that you want to talk to your doctor about, because there is a possibility that if you take too much, that can actually cause some of the issues that you're trying to treat. Too much vitamin A supplementation can actually cause blurry vision, poor nighttime, more glare, halos. And so you want to be careful with this, and something that you definitely want to talk to your doctor about if you want to consider that. But just know it is out there. Now, speaking of supplements, a supplement that you might want to look into are supplements with lutein and zeaxanthin in it. Studies have shown that it actually can improve pigment or pigmented layers in the retina, and that pigment acts as an extra layer that can absorb light or even block a little bit of light. It's kind of like having sunglasses right on your retina. And so if you're someone that's a little bit light sensitive with the bright headlights or the street lights, you might want to look into these supplements, because it has been shown to help a lot of people. Now, having gone through this video, which section was your favorite? Which one do you think will actually help you the most, or which has helped you the most? Leave them in the comments, or if you have any questions, leave them down there. I'll try and answer them as well. And again, check out the description. I'll put further resources and links and video links to other videos where I went into more detail. I hope this helped. Check out my other videos right here, and stay focused.